Treasure loved the beach. Every day she'd play in the rolling waves and dream of adventure. Most cats are afraid of water, but not Treasure. Treasure was sweet and brave and playful and, most of all, curious. One day, Treasure was curious about the sea, so she stowed away on a ship. She dreamed of collecting beautiful treasures and trinkets from faraway lands. Little did Treasure know that she was on Prince Eric's ship. Imagine the royal crew's surprise when they discovered a furry little stowaway. Treasure was just as surprised and worried. Would she have to scrub the deck? Would they make her walk the plank? No. Prince Eric wanted to adopt Treasure and sail the seas with her. The curious kitten with the shiny red hair reminded him of someone he loved very much. And that special someone would be boarding the royal ship that day. All hands and paws were on deck for the occasion. While the prince led Princess Ariel aboard, a sea breeze blew a string of seashells. Treasure leaped to paw at it, and the sound caught Ariel's attention. She turned to see Treasure. Ariel picked up the kitten and cuddled her close. Treasure smelled of the sea, which made Ariel very happy. Treasure purred softly in the princess's arms. When the ship returned to port, Treasure followed Ariel to her palace. Treasure is now Ariel's little treasure, and they collect trinkets and swim together all day long. Sultan may have been a little tiger, but he always tried to be brave. When he wasn't roaming the jungle, roaring and protecting his friends, Sultan could be found at the Agrabah market, guarding fancy silk fabrics. Sultan was rewarded for his bravery, but what he really wanted was a home of his own to protect. One afternoon, Sultan snuggled up for a cat nap and was soon dreaming. At the same time, Princess Jasmine was wandering the market, enjoying the scent of spices and fresh-cut flowers. At the silk stand, she touched the smooth, cool fabric, imagining a new dress. But when her hand brushed something fluffy, a little tiger appeared. Sultan had forgotten all about guarding the silk fabrics. Jasmine had forgotten all about a new dress. What she really wanted was Sultan. The merchant would miss the little tiger, but he knew Sultan would have a good life with the princess. As they left the market, Jasmine told Sultan all about her palace. That's when he realized he was going to have a home of his own. Sultan may be a little tiger, but he always does his best to protect his home and his princess. Every day in the village square, Teacup the pup performed for the villagers, hoping someone would notice her. Someday she found it easy to shine. And was rewarded with treats. Other days, Teacup found it hard to shine. One bright morning, Teacup was performing her signature move when she saw a beautiful girl walk by. It wasn't just any girl, it was Belle. Teacup had seen the princess from afar before. But today, Belle had stopped to watch her perform. Just then, Sunlight caught in one of Belle's golden earrings, blinding the peppy little pup. The teacup atop her head wobbled, then it toppled to the ground and broke. The villagers shook their heads in sympathy and slowly left Teacup alone. But the princess stayed. She knelt down and picked up the broken pieces of the teacup. "Don't worry, sweet little pup. I'll help you," said Belle. Then she carried Teacup home. At Belle's palace, Teacup was presented with her teacup perfectly repaired. And there were treats. Teacup had dreamed of being noticed. Now, she is Belle's little star, performing just for the princess. Unless she's performing in the village square, where she always wears sunglasses. Beauty loved to sleep in the morning sunshine, the afternoon shade, and, of course, the evening moonlight. The other kittens teased that she'd need a prince to wake her. Little did they know, a princess would. Princess Aurora was no stranger to sleeping. It was well known throughout the kingdom that she was called Sleeping Beauty and that she had been woken from a spell with a kiss. Today, Aurora was frolicking in the palace garden with her fairy friends. The sweet scent of new roses was spellbinding, and it took all of her willpower not to settle down for a catnap. But her friends weren't ready to rest. "Look," hollered Merryweather as she hovered above a rosy tail. "It's a lion! It's a tiger! It's a dragon!" Aurora wasn't falling for it. In fact, she was just about to lay her head down when Merryweather and Fauna flew over. "Do take a look," said Fauna. Aurora followed them to the rosy tail, but it didn't belong to a lion or a tiger or a dragon. It belonged to a Sleeping Beauty. Aurora had never seen such a beautiful kitten. Her rosy fur shimmered in the sunshine. Her little pink nose glowed. And her purr was like beautiful music. Merryweather and Fauna bounced about Beauty, trying to wake her with a little magic. Aurora didn't want to disturb the kitten, but it was too late. Beauty had become aware of a breeze tickling her nose and the warm sun disappearing behind a cloud. She opened her eyes and saw a princess. Aurora was sure this surprised kitten would arch her back and hiss. But Beauty just yawned sweetly, then leaped into Aurora's arms. The princess sang to Beauty until she was again purring and asleep. The fairies giggled. "You're perfect for each other, dear," said Flora. Now, the two beauties curl up together for long, luxurious naps, always waking just in time for yummy treats.
Summer loved long days in the meadow, but by late afternoon, she was ready for something new. She had stalked through the bushes, playing peekaboo with the birds. She had even daydreamed about climbing trees, something she'd never done before. Then Summer noticed a large tree nearby, she decided to investigate. Before she knew it, she had climbed up onto a branch. It was easy. A little while later, it started to rain. Lightning cracked and thunder boomed. Summer tried to climb down, but now the tree was too wet. Meanwhile, Rapunzel had been seeking the perfect place to picnic when she was caught in the unexpected shower, too. Summer saw that the girl was coming closer. Maybe she'd know what to do. Just as Rapunzel was about to set down her basket and dry her face, thunder roared again. Summer cried out in fear. Rapunzel looked up and saw the helpless kitten. Rapunzel knew right away that Summer was afraid. Once, Rapunzel had been very afraid. But after leaving her tower, she discovered that she was brave and strong. So Rapunzel decided to help. She climbed the tree easily. And there, high above the ground, a kitten met a princess. Being so far up is a little scary, isn't it? Said Rapunzel. But what an adventure we're having, she continued. And look, the rain has stopped. Summer purred in Rapunzel's arms. All that climbing had made Summer and Rapunzel hungry. So they picnicked right there in the tree. It was the perfect spot. After lunch, Rapunzel showed Summer how to climb down. Then she led the kitten to her castle. With Rapunzel as her new friend, Summer has found countless adventures. And a place to call home. Thank you.